fake!
Oh, someone's getting tortured in here.
You will break.
I will die first. Or you will. You're alive.
Oh, God. Leliana's seen some shit. I kind of figured they were gonna make me feel bad about this. Oh, no. Leliana. This is bad.
Well, that was impressive.
Anger is stronger than any pain. Do you have weapons? Good. The Magister's probably in his chambers.
You aren't curious how we got here?
No.
Alexius sent us into the future. This, his victory, his elder one, it was never meant to be.
I need to find Alexius and reverse the spell.
If we can get back to our present time, we can prevent this future from ever happening.
And mages always wonder why people fear them. No one should have this power.
It's dangerous and unpredictable. Before the breach, nothing we did.
Enough. This is all pretend to you. Some future you hope will never exist. I suffered. The whole world suffered. It was real.
Oh, man. I get the feeling that whether you pick mage or templar, they're gonna make you feel really bad about your decision.
Stop talking.
I'm just asking for information.
No, you're talking to fill silence. Nothing happened that you want to hear.
Oh, God. I feel so bad about Leliana right now. That's really fucked up. There's nothing in the room besides this one. Is it a key? It's probably a key. They probably had. I'd probably need to get a key in order to progress because they wanted to make me finding Leliana mandatory, I'm sure. Oh god, she's in a bad shape. Okay, let's just keep it going. What is this? At least I have a fifth party member now. I mean, not a real party member, but a fifth person to help in fights, so. The good news is the tide should be sufficiently turned at this point in favor of me.
We need to find Alexius. I'm sure he'll be in the nicer part of the castle, if there is one.
It's a rift. Oh, okay. I have to pummel some of these guys away in order to even properly fight. Oh, right. I have to kind of manually trigger everyone to actually fight, don't I? Because they'll just hang around like jackasses. Actually, no, I just have to tell Solas to get busy, more or less, huh? So, make sure that you start fighting this person just so that you're doing something. And Vasti will fight this person. And everyone will die one by one. And hopefully Leliana's helping too. This should work out. Hit things really hard until they die is the strategy. Okay. So I'm gonna take control of Vasti, and I'm gonna try to, while I'm guarded by people, I'm gonna try to disrupt the rift. So really bring an end to the fight. Alright, now everyone's screwed. Oh, anyone left? Oh, round two, okay. Dory needs to heal real quick. We'll disrupt this as fast as ow. Disrupt this as fast as possible. If I can just hide behind a wall, we're set. Come on. We did it, alright. Now they're in trouble. Come on, all over. Everyone's currently fighting someone, right? Okay, yeah, everyone's fighting someone. I just want to make sure that no one's, like, just standing around right now. Did we win? Not quite. Okay. I keep trying to do that as if it's going to work. It's never going to work. Shout a little bit of guard. There we go. So we should have basically won at this point. I think it'll just close now. Right? There we go, we win. Okay. That was a little tough. Not because the encounter itself was tough, but just because we keep getting more encounters. Enhanced Blizzard Ring. Oh, right. I was going through my items and I forgot to check out the my new accessory, the barrier penetration. 5% damage bonus against barriers versus heal on kill, stagger on hit. We have a lot of things to put on, potentially. I'm currently wearing an amulet of strength. I have the stagger on hit, and I have heal on kill. God, 2% healing per kill is not very good healing. I should probably just put on a barrier penetration. Which one's which? Shit. Oh yeah, just take it off. There we go. If I just take it off, I can tell which hand to put it in. We have some life ward amulets for some reason. I might as well give someone else the life drain ring, just because not everyone... Like Dorian, for example, just doesn't even have rings on, so he might as well wear something, because it's better than nothing. Yep, walking bomb is a mage skill. Don't know what it is. Oh, wait. What if I look into... If I look into Dorian's skills... I can confirm. Is it one of these? Chaotic focus, wall of fire, clean burn, immolate. No. I don't know what walking bomb is. Is it somewhere in the ice tree? Because I never really looked at that one. Energy, static, get it. I'm going as fast as I can through some of the stuff. Yeah, I don't see walking bomb anywhere in the mage skills, so I suspect that means that, I think the game sort of, just like how it spoiled the Iron Bold's existence by giving me an amulet of power for him, I think we're getting more and more evidence that, there's more classifications later, which makes sense, because I'm only, like, level 6 and 7 and stuff, and I'm already getting close to maxing out individual trees, so it makes sense that more trees get unlocked as we progress. The important thing, though, is what skills does Dorian have? Fire, Mind, Flash, Fire, Immolate, because I might have a ring for one of those, in which case we should definitely put it on. Immolate ring. There we go. This one gives me 30% ability duration for immolate. Good to have. Okay. We just increased our situation a bit by re-equipping our party. So now it's time to move forward, I guess, by turning this crank. How's the map looking, by the way? So we're currently on this floor. We have to go up 1, 2, 3 floors to reach the next goal, which may or may not be the boss. It does look like there's something above it. It looks like I have to hold this. There we go. Alrighty then. What's gonna happen up here? We discovered the docks? Why would a floor of the castle this high be called the docks? That's weird. Oh!
The Magister needs more power for his rituals.
No! Don't hurt me, Linnea.
So there's people hurting each other nearby that know each other, which is pretty fucked up. And it looks like we just reached the ground floor, so everything we've seen so far was underground. This place, Redcliffe, has a really extensive underground dungeon. And the question is, how did we get there? Okay. I generated guard, and then immediately got taken down to nothing anyway. That was devastating. I think I can trust my characters to kind of handle this fight. There we go. What is happening back there? Oh no. Solus, please don't die. No,
Alexius can't have wanted.
God damn it, Solus. I'm very disappointed in you right now. I can't escape this. No. I'm stuck in a glitch. I can't pause the game. I can't change characters. I can't select skills. I can't enter tactical mode. Alright, I'm gonna load my save. I'll see you guys when I get back here. Yay! Jesus, I can't even load my save by pausing it. I have to quit out the entire game. Okay, guys, holy fuck. It actually auto-saved here. I have to load it. Now I have to close the game again, and open it again, and then manually choose an older save, because it actually auto-saved at this moment. Why? The good news is we're back! The bad news is it took a long ass time to get back here and everything. The good news is that I got a new item for Solus. That encounter with the rift back there, someone dropped a ring of power, I don't know, whatever they call the ones that power up spells. It was one for Winter's Grasp, his one ice spell that he's using to his sort of one complementary attack that he has to work with the rest of his moves that are just for defense purposes. So, at least something came out. At least something good came out of all that, where I got a ring that's actually useful for the current loadout I have for characters, especially since Solas doesn't currently have any other spells. Okay, supply cache. That'll give us some potions, so we definitely want to recover right now. Probably the characters that don't automatically bubble when they go low on health. Okay. So how much does it refill me is the question. It refills me... Oh, right back to up to 8. Okay, so I have maximum potions again, which is good to have. We're ready to move forward, I think. Jeez. Alright, so at least they're nice about how often they give me the supplies. It very much feels like Dark Souls in that way, where they're very carefully measuring how much healing I'm allowed to do. Although I still... In an RPG, I do generally... If it's a party-based RPG, I do miss the idea of just having someone who heals people. I feel like that's just a normal role to have. Although having someone who can spout out barriers is a little more... It's still handy.
It's everywhere.
The Elder One and his Venatori. They are the ones who opened the breach.
Well. This certainly is the apocalypse, the breach... So without me around for a year, the breach kept spreading. So we're getting a glimpse... So not only are they doing the classic thing that, like, Telltale games will often do, for example, where they like, oh, you're gonna pick between mages and Templars, time to immediately make you feel bad about your decision, haha, here's how horrible mages are, right after you pick to choose to side with the mages. Oh god. There's a rift. Disrupt this as fast as possible. Ow, nope, they're not gonna let me get away with that. Okay, let's do some focus firing right off the bat. Just make a big mess of things. Do I have another heal over time spell? I don't. I just have to kind of grit my teeth and go with it. So much potential incoming damage, too. This is not really ideal. Okay. Let's do a quick heal before you go down. There we go. Can Solas cast bubble? I need to keep an eye on him. Yes. There we go. People are a little spread out. That's annoying. I'm gonna quickly switch back out. I'm gonna run into the area with Vasti a little. Nope. I tried. Solas just auto-bubbled instead. Oh well. I figured I'd try to run on foot close to the enemies so that the bubble would happen. Alright, let's deal with this rift as fast as possible. And here comes another wave, right? Yep. There's one wraith right on us, so he makes a clear candidate for a first target. And he's down already. Nope, he bubbled. He'll be down in a second, though. I'll go ahead and use my... Let's have a Warcry, and can Cassandra use Warcry right now? No, she can't. Okay. Cassandra's doing great on armor generation, though. Holy shit, she has her guard way up all the time. So I'll use Vasti's guard. There we go. Now Cassandra's losing all of her guard. Oh, man. It does seem to be handy as a warrior to get a bunch of skills that generate guard and then spam them, because holy shit, your health goes down so fast. Still going down fast regardless, though, unfortunately. I don't have a lot of solutions for the amount of just damage coming at me all the time. Let's see, Dorian, do you have any fun spells you can throw out there, or are you out of magic? You're out of magic, but at least I can make you target this guy that's going down in a moment. Let's see, is there anyone else weak I can go after? That guy's weak. Okay, Dorian, I'm having Dorian and Solas target the guys that are most likely to go down first. Because decreasing their numbers is no small feat. There we go, and we'll do a bubble. Yep, got everybody. We're doing a little better now. Take this opportunity to try to, oh! What am I doing? Oh, I'm looting. I'm trying to, I wanted to seal the breach. There we go. This should hopefully wrap things up. Nope. Oh, let's get it closed. Get it closed. Alright, we should be good. There we go. Huh. Things got a little messy in there, but it definitely helped to... Target the people that are about to go down, because that reduces the enemies, which means you're reducing incoming damage. Just doing flat damage all around just to random people is not as effective as getting individual weaker enemies down faster, just because you reduce the number of damage sources coming in, which is pretty vital in a difficulty like this, where all the damage sources are almost unavoidable. Okay. So we're down to 3 potions out of 8 already, which is not a good shape to be in. And there's another rift there. Oh, and I can't go around it either. Looks like this has to happen. Okay. There's no way up? Nope, you have to go up these stairs to continue. And we probably can't just run for it. We probably can't use doors while we're in combat. So, I'm gonna say let's have everyone attack this group. And I'll keep an eye on Vasti and see if I can find an opening. Oops, accidentally left the tactic screen. So if everyone's sufficiently distracting, I might be able to run away as Vasti. And get a clear disrupt moment. Oh, please. There we go. Prompt. They're not coming for me yet. Oh crap, Cassandra's going down. There we go. So they should be stunned, which will at least help to some extent. I'm trying to take a trip up here to get out of line of sight a bit. So hopefully help. There we go. No, it's not letting me disrupt the rift at all. It's unfortunate. Okay. Who do we have? Dorian. Everyone's kind of wandering around a bit. Let's try to have them focused in a group a bit more. There we go. Everyone's a little more focused now. I'm going to keep Vasti up here, though, if I can. What's that? Oh, is that a wraith? Crap, that wraith's going to shoot me if I try to disrupt the rift, isn't he? Just give me the prompt. Maybe I'll get... Oh, did not get away with it. There's still one shooting at me. This was a... and now I'm down. That's all around bad. Okay. Let's get Solas out of here as fast as I can. Good thing about Solas is that he self-bubbles when he's about to go down, which means I actually can retreat without straight up losing, usually. Break line of sight. The question is, can I even escape? Okay, I can escape. Huh. That was problematic. So let's see... Let's see who has heal over time potions, because those people should use those immediately. Cassandra. I don't think Dorian... Yeah, Dorian has no potions, and Vasti just doesn't have any left. So, I say Vasti and Dorian probably have to manually heal. There we go. We'll wait for the heal over time to happen. And we'll have to go back into there and try to finish this. Huh. It's a little difficult. It's tough. They give you the ability to stun everyone, but in order to do that, you have to establish line of sight with the rift, be close to the rift, and then channel one spell for a pretty long time without any interruption. And then by the time you manage to do that, oftentimes, frankly, it might not even be worth it because your whole party just takes damage in the meantime, just fighting people off. I'm thinking I might be better off having Vasti just attack directly. Oh no! Did the rift restart completely? The shades are back. I think I have to start the entire thing over. Oh well, let's just commit, I guess. So focus fire. Come on. We should be able to do something here. Okay, Vasti, I need you to use your war cry. I made it a priority skill for a reason, because it gives you armor to keep you going. Okay. Okay, so let's definitely focus on this asshole, because he's getting attacked. I'm trying to attack my mages right now. We can't have that. That was a very well-timed bubble from Solas to save, very quickly save Dorian's life. It's back Dorian away, and Solas in a different direction, just to deal with the fact that everyone's trying to jump on top of them right now. Oh, whoa! How'd my camera even get over here? That was weird. It just kind of teleported in one frame of animation. Let's see, let's make sure that Cassandra... Yeah, Cassandra will focus on this one, and Vasti will focus on this bottom one. And he'll do a mighty blow, try to wipe him out. Stay down! He's defeated. Okay. Good news is they went down, the bad news is we have no healing potions. The moment that Dorian gets hit, he's going down. We do still have backup from Leliana, though, so we might be able to pull this around. It's hard to say. This is, by and large, not an ideal situation. Okay. Okay, I was running in to deal with... Okay, never mind. Oh, he's down immediately. Okay, that was my mistake. Huh. Is Dorian even in line of sight to deal with stuff? I guess he is. Is Solas too far away? Where'd Solas go? Oh, that's not where I told you to stand. Oh, well. We'll be fine. Let's see. Oh, you don't have the mana to resurrect, unfortunately. Okay, well then we'll have people focus fire for now. Is that Cassandra? Yeah, it is. We'll have to just focus fire and hopefully we can weather through this a bit. Wraiths usually aren't super tough, and once Solas has enough mana, he can resurrect people at least. Oh, we are in trouble now. Okay. So let's try to revive people. There we go, everyone's back alive for the time being. It's not going to be a very long-term solution, though. How many enemies are left? We have, one Wraith, two Wraith, three Wraith, four Wraith, a glowy bit that might, I don't think is another Wraith. Do we just have four Wraiths right now? Did I count this one right here? I think I did. This is, not ideal. Everyone's going to go down really quickly here. I can try to make Cassandra heal over time. And I can try to use a firebomb. I don't know if it works against wraiths. It's worth a shot because there's two of them over here in line of sight with one firebomb. And we'll have Vasti use a war cry just to try to generate more armor. And we'll have Cassandra use hers as fast as possible too. Quickly! Oh, she doesn't have the stamina for it, does she? Okay, that kind of helped keep her going a bit longer. Oh, and Solas had enough for a barrier. Okay, how many enemies are left? I think these guys... Wow, did they both go down immediately? This might be our only enemy left. Let's focus on him then. I think that grenade actually wiped them out. Oh, nope, there's still one standing in there. He's over here. I couldn't even see him past all the fire. And also the game didn't automatically lock on him. Alright, let's watch his health and see if it's going down from the fire. Yeah, he's dying. Oh, he moved out of it. He's still probably burned for a bit though. Where is he? He's moving around a little bit. Now, he'll die in a moment here just from the fire, I think. So let's focus on this guy trying to go down. Come on. Come on. Oh, man. This is closer than it needs to be. Oh, son of a bitch. This guy also survived the fire? Okay. Is this guy still burning over here? Oh, yeah. He's dead. Okay. We're down to one enemy left. Not ideal. A lot of people are about to go down. It's not in any way ideal. How is this guy doing? He's still pretty far off from being able to cast his, I'll use a healing over time potion. He's a little far off from being able to cast his resurrection to get, Dorian back up. We'll just have to hope that pure DPS can take this guy out first. And then once this guy's down, I think we'll be free to take on the, okay, two people are down. But if there's no more enemies, we're free to take on the Rift, because I should be able to get people to come back up now. Alright, let's get Vasti back up. Okay, he's up. Huh. This is chaos. Hopefully I don't have to resupply in order to finish this place. Because it would be handy to have regeneration potions for everyone so they could heal between fights. Looks like Cassandra self-healed. Or actually, I think that's just the heal. I think I gave her a heal during the fight. Might have forgotten. There's a lot to keep track of. Let's see here. Anyone around? We have a little bit of loot. Toxic Cloud Ring. No one knows Toxic Cloud right now, I don't think, but I'll keep it in mind. I mean, sooner or later, I'll just have a ring for every skill in the game, right? And then I won't have to... Then it'll just be a nice little benefit. Just do a quick scan for any beneficial items that may have come out of this. Not so much. Here's hoping the very next room has, like, a cache for potions in it, because otherwise I'm in trouble. Because I do not have much to keep my party alive at this point. And that is not a good moment to have. What are we going to see in here? Come on, supply cache. The upper royal wing. Does the upper royal wing have fucking potions in it? Because that's the main thing I care about. Come on. Just empty room. It's in this room. There's loot. Loot's not bad, but it's not potions. Dagger grip and elven cowl. It's good to get more recipes for everybody, at least. Alexius's journal. Ooh, we get to read into the mind of the madman. Did that give me 75? I think that gave me 75 experience. I guess it made sense because I got the thing where... That magic thing for the Inquisition where I got 50% bonus experience from Codex entries. I don't know if it's just all Codex entries or magic Codex entries, though. This appears to be Alexius's journal. This is the final entry. Nothing works. I have tried countless times to go back before the Conclave explosion, before Felix's caravan was attacked by Darkspawn, before Venatori's first arrived in Minrathus, without success. The breach is the wellspring that makes this magic possible, and travel outside its timeline is impossible. The Elder Ones demand that I change the events of the Conclave can never be fulfilled. He may kill me for failing him, but I must protect Felix from his wrath. So all of this is him trying to... Because Felix is dying, he's trying to go back and prevent him from being attacked by Darkspawn and getting the Darkspawn sickness, I assume. I assume that's what his sickness is. And so he's trying to go back and stop Felix from getting attacked in the first place. But because the breach is what gave him the ability to use this power, he can't go to a time where the breach doesn't exist. Huh. Surprised he was able to send us into the future then. Like, what if in the real story I destroy the breach before this time happens? Does that mean he wouldn't have been able to send me in the future in the first place? There might be a paradox there. Because the breach does have to exist for me to be sent somewhere then.
No!
Who's dead? Oh shit, did they kill Qunari?
Qunari!
It was an act of courage. He knew there was no other way to resist. He resisted that demon to the last.
Where's Qunari? I'm sorry, I'm missing the detail here. Because Qunari is the child that I saved the life of. His mom sacrificed himself to save him because he was possessed by a demon. Where is he? I don't see him in here. What are we reacting to? Is he in the fire? He's not in the fire. What did we just react to? I don't see him around. Is he hanging from the ceiling? No. All right, let's check is he in here? Spellbinder's journal. With every failed time spell, the Magister grows a bit more paranoid, or perhaps it's not paranoia, since the Elder One really will kill him for his failures. The distinction hardly matters. After the 10th failure, he began locking himself in the Great Hall during his waking hours. After the 20th, he had the foot soldiers excavate a shard doorway from parts unknown and painstakingly install it in the castle. Now, his most trusted assistants can only see him if we all go at once, together. Which we must do twice a day to bring him his meals, and he never leaves that room at all. I bet that he's some sort of abomination now because of all the magic that he's been screwing with all this time. There's probably something really wrong with... Oh, that's Qunari. Is that Qunari? No, that's just soldiers. What are we shouting? Is Qunari in here? Did I just not notice him a moment ago? There's a bear head? I don't think I've seen any evidence about something happening to Qunari yet, so I don't know what we were just shouting about. Maybe he's in here. So we need to find Arl. Ooh, thank goodness we have a supply cache. I have no... Yeah, I can't pre-use any potions,
what
unfortunately.
What became of Felix? Do you know?
There we go.
I know.
And you're not going to tell me?
You'll find out soon enough.
Oh, is Felix the abomination? Has he been trying to fix Felix over and over with magic, and now Felix is, like, totally screwed? Because that's possible. I'm definitely saving. Still continuing to use a separate save so I don't override my earlier stuff in case I have to... try again with better supplies. Definitely never want to get stuck in a point of no return in this game, although this zone hasn't been super hard yet, aside from a few too many rifts back to back being a problem. Apprentice mail. What are we going to find down here? The lower royal wing. What does the map look like right now? We're on the floor of our... Oh, there we go. Here on the right is where we're trying to go for the throne room. And there's one floor above us. Oh, I've already been there. We actually came back down now, so this is pretty much the only place left in the entire map, and then we'll be done with this dungeon, I assume. Man, Redcliffe, oh my god, there's a lot of red dots behind that door. Do I have to? What is it? Are they fighting each other? Oh! There's a war happening behind there. Should I even take part, or should I wait? They're all enemies. I could just wait for them to hurt each other a lot. Because there's a bad tendency for them to all to... Oftentimes, they all seem to turn on me at the same time, which is a problem. Alright, those archers are down. Because, yeah, when I fight two opposing forces in the hinterlands, they often both turn on me simultaneously. What am I looting here? Samite. Okay. So what do we have around here? It's another rift. We have Lesser Shade. Oh, there's still a spell. There's still a spellbinder in here to have a fight. Lesser Shade. And over here is my goal. Is that doorway? It looks like. So we have one, two. We have like four shades, I think, versus one spellbinder. And I think that's everyone in the room. Are they not going to attack that spellbinder? Are they somehow allied with each other? Oops, did we just start fighting over here? Someone might have just aggroed on us. Okay, well, let's just go ahead and have everyone focus fire on that shade. And I'm going to take manual control of my main character, because I might be able to disrupt the fade from here. Is it not going to give me an opportunity to interact with fade from here? I'm in like direct line of sight. Okay. Well, let's deal with assholes. Fall over. Yeah, that's what's happening right now. Enjoy this. Come on. Alright, come at me, bro. Deflect. Oh, I thought I was trying to deflect his ability. Didn't work out for me. Whirlwind. That's right, get both of them at once. That worked out for me. Can I do it now? No, I still can't deflect it. Is there like a line of sight problem? Does that railing count as a wall? Oh god, how bad did things just get? Why is this... The spellbinder does not count. He's not fighting the shades for some reason. Well, clearly we're going to have to focus fire on him then if he's going to be a problem. Let's tell my main character to mighty blow him. Tell Cassandra to do a... get a bunch of guard. Let's see if we can get this guy down as fast as possible. I'll do a war cry of my own for more armor. Did we lose him? Did he teleport? Oh, he did. That pain in the ass. Okay. First of all, can you resurrect people? You probably can't because of your mana, huh? You're probably waiting to do that right now. Okay. We'll just have to keep this going. Who should I focus on? We'll find a shade that has the least hit points, I think. So it's this one right here. It's our best bet to just decrease the incoming damage in general. Oh, Cassandra charged straight through. Oh. And she left Vasili to die. That was not ideal. Shit. You're not at all waiting for an opportunity to attack with the... I need you to be resurrected from people, dude. Okay, you've done goofed, haven't you? Oh, shit. I was waiting for an opportunity to resurrect. Okay, I messed up. I messed up bad. I'm gonna see if I can set up a more defensive formation here with the two melee in the front and the two spellcasters in the back. Hey, Liliana's even especially in the middle. Way to go. And I think we just wait for aggro to happen. Or not. Or aggro won't happen at all. Okay. I'm gonna take over... Really, the moment I enter... Okay, it's still there. Okay. I'm gonna try to grapple this asshole over here then. Come here, asshole. Okay. Best chance is just to have everyone obliterate this guy as fast as possible. First of all, I'm gonna try to mighty blow him to knock him the hell over. Nope, didn't work. It's not okay. There we go. Never mind. It did work. Leliana, I really wish you had control of you so you would attack who I want you to. There we go. Spellcaster's almost. Oh, teleported. That's a bad thing. Okay, so I'm getting. Maybe I should just chase him. Actually, maybe I can hit him with a grappling chain. Nope, grappling chain did not work. Okay, and people are going down. How are we doing on potions? Okay, so I'll keep an eye on it, but I don't want to use potions yet because people can take a little more damage first. I'll use a war cry. Can't use a war cry on Cassandra right now. There we go. Some bonus armor to keep me going. And I say maybe we just need to commit to taking this guy the fuck out. Just charge in and take him out. I can take some shades out afterwards, but this guy is. I think this guy has potentially the highest damage output. Where did he get? He left again. Oh, joke's on you. Everyone's ready to deal with you there. You're in line of sight. Come on, finish him. There we go. He's down. So now there's no spellcaster on their team. Now they're just a bunch of random ass shades. There's four of them total. So we just need to get busy getting them down now. Let's go ahead and heal. Yeah, definitely heal protagonist. There we go. Are you ready to bubble yet? Not ready to bubble. Okay. So we're just going to have to try to see how we can play this out. Oh, of course the one that I tell everyone to attack gets stuck awkwardly behind everybody. You know what? Let's just commit. Do a smash attack. Ruin his day. There we go. Another war cry for more armor. Keeps me going a bit because I'm definitely losing armor. He's almost down. There we go. So next up, we should focus on the one that's close. Oh, no. Focus on this guy. He's got no hit points left. Just get him down instantly. He's down. Focus on this guy. I think he has the least next compared. Nope, this guy does. Everyone, we just need to focus fire on anyone who's closest to dying. There we go. Now we're down to one enemy, which means we have a relatively lower amount of damage coming in, so my party should be just fine now. Unfortunately, there's almost certainly a whole extra phase to this fight that I have to fight my way through, so let's get healed up for the people that need it. I don't need to heal Solas yet, because Solas can self-bubble a bit, so he's a little more survivable. So will it let me disrupt the rift? That heal? It's not letting me disrupt the rift at all. Okay. So what's our... Oh! Got hit by stuff. We have lesser shade. Lesser shade. Oh, a wraith. Wraiths are good people to attack, I think, because they, I think wraiths... Because they do magic, I assume they do more damage, but they're also easier to kill. So it looks like we have four lesser shades and a wraith. Each lesser shade has 2,000 hit points. The wraith has 700. So I will say... Let's say focus our melee characters on this shade. I don't know why that happened. Sometimes when I switch characters, it just decides that it's no longer in tactical mode. I'm gonna focus my ranged characters on, oops, wrong character, on dealing with this this wraith right here. Because the faster he goes down, the better. I'm gonna get ready to bubble too. Here it comes. All right, need to bubble as best as we can. I can only reach our melee characters. They need it the most. How's the wraith is not quite down yet. I do need to deal with the fact that there's a freaking shade right on top of us. Let's progress this a little more and see how it goes down. Are we doing okay? The wraith is there. Yeah, it's hard to target the wraith from here. Who's hurting this guy? Is it just Leliana? Okay, I might have to switch targets just to deal with whoever I can to, No, I'll commit for a little longer. In a bad spot, I can usually revive somebody with, Solas. It's tense, because it's hard to make decisions in this situation. Okay, there's three lesser shades. This one's almost down. The wraith is down, so that's one damage source gone. Leliana's almost down, unfortunately. Wow, 22 hit points. Not ideal. See, the people... Who's this red... Oh, there's one right here. We're going to want to focus fire on this guy as much as possible, just because he's about to go down. And I'm going to want to heal in a moment with... There we go. Definitely heal with Solas. Vasti to get him up, because Vasti was about to go down completely. He just got bubbled. He's got armor. Okay, things are going better now. Okay, so what's left of the shades? This one's about to go down, so focus on him for sure. What about... Oh, that one's completely dead, huh? Okay, good. Good. This is turning around very quickly. The good thing about Dorian is one hell of a damage source, as you're probably noticing. It might be fun to have, I wonder what'll happen if I bring Dorian and Viven into one fight. The problem is that I'd have to basically lose my damage, my defensive capabilities. But their damage output might be so devastating in conjunction with each other that it might not matter. Because Dorian and Viven can both initiate combos, but then Dorian also has a combo trigger, and also my main character has a combo trigger.
Alexius will likely be there.
Oh man, I'm concerned about this idea of going to the main hall. The good news is I've cleared the way to basically the end of the instance, probably. The bad news is I am out of supplies. So I'm wondering, can I find supplies around here? There's doors to open. Is it just going to be random secret stuff around? Ooh! Supply cache. Okay. So let's have Dorian heal up, because he's the lowest. And get our healing potions back. Huh. So which way am I trying to go to continue? I'm supposed to go that way, right? Yeah. So I'm gonna check out this area first, just to see if I can benefit from exploring a bit. We'll see where this takes me. The upper royal wing. Now where am I?
How much damage did Alexius' spell do?
Quite a bit, apparently.
Rift tore apart all of Southern Thedas, starting here. But whether that's his doing or the breach, who can say?
Yeah, Leliana won't, even though she's my intel person, she won't have a ton of intel on this situation because she's been stuck inside of, she's been stuck in a cell and tortured for so long. Let's see. Oh, something to read? Or not. Oh, it's a schematic. Okay. Masterwork Wave Blade. What does that do? Because that sounds awesome. Where is this going to take me? Oh, these doors have enemies behind them. Do I want to fight more enemies or do I want to continue on? Oh, you can find red lyrium shards. What is that going to do for me? I really wish I had a rogue. That was a mistake on my part. Man, there's so many directions to go in. I'm just concerned I'm going to get myself screwed, though, on potions. You know what? All I have to do is make a manual save. If I make a manual save, then if doing the side content gets me too screwed on potions, then I can make up for it. Hey, asshole. You're going down, buddy. You're going down so hard. Enjoy. Yay, 5-on-1. No regrets because these guys torture people. I feel entirely justified in my actions. And he's dead. Wow, exploded. Neato. Oh, I can bash this wall in. That's awesome. What's behind this wall? What am I going to find around here? Some kind of wine cellar. Oh, this is the door that I was going to have to open with a rogue. Looks like I was able to just beat my way in. We've got Free Marcher's Helmet. Some sort of crazy cask. I don't think I can interact with this place very much. Is it just a cool room? Is that a sword and a pumpkin? That's a sword and a pumpkin. Why is there a pumpkin there? That might be an Easter egg of some kind. Cause that's just weird. Really, there's nothing in here. Huh. I expected to find a lot more in here. Alright, so we have two enemies. Oh, I can bash that wall too, and it'll have enemies behind it. Loot this. Oh, red lyrium shard. I need three more for whatever this requirement is. If I look at my map, will it tell me why I'm collecting red lyrium shards right now? Not necessarily. Okay. It might just be useful for me against the boss in some way. Studies on the Blight. Introduction of Blight to prisoners yields no discrete discernible pattern. They're giving the Blight to people on purpose. That's kind of fucked up. Disease progresses erratically. Some subjects die within hours despite all efforts. Others show no symptoms at all. Subjects may harbor some natural resistance, which makes isolation and testing a priority. A later entry follows. 6 more subjects dead. Transfusions of blood from resistant prisoners slow the rate of corruption only slightly. Healthy flesh taken from live subjects and implanted in the infected will often die even before corruption spreads it. In cases where the implantation is successful, blight corruption spreads across the donor flesh faster than the host flesh. Prisoner Leliana has been most useful source of resistant blood and skin to date. Oh, God. So they've been cutting up and draining Leliana and using her in experiments because she's resilient to the blight. That explains how really fucked up she looks. This is... Everything's really unfortunate in here. Okay, so what do we have here? This guy reacted really fast to this door being beat down. He's already in the doorway. We have one zealot. Is there anyone else around here? We have a table. Corpse. A bloody corpse. Oh! Oh, there's two zealots. One of them's just sort of inside the wall right now. Okay. Well, let's focus fire as much as we can. And I'm going to personally open with a war cry for bonus armor. Did that work? I think it worked. Oh, they're both taking damage too. This is working out. Alright, take that fucker down. Knock him down. Oh, is he dead? He's dead. Okay. I focus on the other one. A nice, big, strong attack really just completely disables them. Knocking them over and just giving them an opportunity to take more damage from the fire over time is great. It seems to be a good strategy to have Dorian around, have him cast fire spells on people, and then incapacitate people while they're on fire, so that they're just taking the damage over time and can't do anything about it. Seems to be very effective. Just set the damage over time, and then just try to put them in a state where they can't fight back, so they don't do long-term damage to the party. Okay, so we fought our way into this room, and there wasn't really much to get out of it, apparently. Really, just some empty rooms. It's kind of a disappointment. Alright, we'll check the other side and continue forward. Need a rogue to open that door, but I might be able to beat my way in if I get in through another door later. Oh, this next room looks dangerous. Okay, quick heal. How bad is it? Zealot, 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 marksman, spellbinder, marksman. So we have six enemies in this room, three zealots, two marksmen, and one spellbinder. I might have to reload my save. This might go south very quickly, unfortunately. At this point, the best I can do is try, right? Okay, let's get right in on that zealot as fast as possible. Alright, now they're all grouped up on me, let's do our war cries as fast. Oops, why did it start doing real time? It keeps doing that, it keeps going into real time when I'm not telling it to. It did it again! It just did it a third time. Wow, I used Warcry on this character apparently, and he's already down to like no hit points left. This is going bad very quickly. We'll see if I can weather it though. Oh, everyone's exploding. That mine that Dorian has is incredibly effective, by the way. You guys dead? So this one guy needs to go down. Is he the only remaining zealot? I don't see another one around. We might have killed two zealots already. Nope, one there. Okay, now we're about to kill two zealots. There we go, two zealots down. Oh, Vasti's down. I should be able to resurrect him, though. So we'll resurrect Vasti real quick. Alright, now everyone focus fire on this zealot. We'll get him down as fast as possible. Oh, did I resurrect Vasti or not? Maybe I failed. Please cast it. There we go, now I actually casted it. It just didn't happen at first. I definitely need my two tanks to regenerate as fast as possible. Come on, get in there and finish him. He's down. Okay, so... Oh. Wait, is he alive or not? He's got zero hit points, but he's bubbled. I assume he'll just die in a moment here, regardless of the bubbling. Alright, so now we're down to the two marksmen and the spellbinder. I'm gonna say... Let's focus on the Spellbinder, because he can buff everyone else, so the longer he's around, the more he's a problem. But I wasn't going to try to force my way past three melee characters just to get the Spellbinder. It didn't seem realistic. They always get in the way. Alright, let's just keep using anything I can use to stun him, so that he can't cast spells. Oh, Vasti's down, and Cassandra's down. Both melee people are down and cannot... Okay. I'm going to... disengage and run the fuck away. Both of my tanks are down. I don't have a res spell active anymore because I already used it, so the best move is just to get the fuck out of here right now. There we go. Then they're just my characters. Yep, everyone, just my guys. No one else followed. Good. Okay, I can heal now and go in anew. Do you have any heal over times left? No, you don't. Okay. This could be going better. But now that I reset the fight, they shouldn't have responded, because I don't think only... Yep, okay. Yeah, only voids respawn when you run away. But running away from a fight against humans just gives you an opportunity to recover. So now we just need to... Come on, knock them over. Yes! Good job. Just keep wailing on this dude. Oh! Still lost Vasti, just like that. Even though I just used a spell that would make me recover... Get a bunch of guard really quick. Alright, the spellcaster's down. That's good. Let's go to the next target that's just closest to Cassandra. I think these marksmen are both at max health, right? Oh no, this one's already lower, actually. We'll focus on him next, just because he can reasonably be taken down faster. It's all about reducing sources of damage as fast as possible. Come on. Oh, and then Vasti's back up. But Vasti has no way of staying alive. Oh, Cassandra's down. Yeah, this is not ideal. This little detour of exploring the castle may be getting me completely wrecked. Unless there's another stash of potions around. Come on, take this fucker down. There we go, he's down. We did it. Huh, chaos.
Have mercy on your souls. No one else will.
Oh god. These poor people are in such a bad shape right now. If I get a little more experience, Vasti should actually level up, which would not hurt getting a additional level that gives you status. It gives you the ability to put one more point on something, and as a result, you get stats too. Because I think most skills in this game actually increase your stats in parallel. Cloak of Shadows Ring. That's definitely a rogue ability. If only I could equip Leliana as if she was a party member, because she's acting like one right now, but I can't customize her in any way to make her more useful or work better with the group. Weird, this brought me upstairs, but there's not really anything up here. Pick. Where are these doors going to take me? There's a few to pick from, right? Was there one down here? No? Okay. Oh, there's two doors. Okay. That one will take me down the hallway. This one will take me back into the room I was already in, maybe? Ah, supply stash. I need those, right? Yeah, I do need those very badly. There we go. People are replenished a little bit. My concern is that I'll run out of supply caches and then run into the boss fight in a bad situation. Although I don't even know that there's a boss fight. Maybe I just get in there and it's like, it's over, everyone's dead. Oh shit, my inventory actually filled. Alright, I have some inventory management to do. I'll be back in a little while, guys.